Officially, Camden Town Hall closed over an hour ago, but inside there are still security men on duty because in the council chamber there are still 70 protesting families. They've brought in extra supplies of blankets and food, and it's obvious they intend to stick it out if need be for the whole weekend.
It was the deaths this week of a mother and her two children in a Marylebone hostel fire that lay behind the protest. Survivors there claim there was no fire escape and that the extinguishers were empty and useless. 80 of Camden's families living in similar homeless hostels protested to Camden Town Hall over what they say is accommodation falling well below the health and fire regulations. At 5 o'clock last night, they occupied the council chamber and have been there ever since. They've spent the day negotiating with councillors and say they'll accept nothing short of immediate rehousing in proper council accommodation.
It is absolutely certain Camden has 700 families in bed and breakfast, that if they don't do something to improve standards, make better accommodation available, further tragedies will occur, and that will be on the heads of the council.
The council have offered short-term council places for 30 protesting families, with hotel and bed and breakfast places for the rest. They say it's as far as they can go.
Well, we simply cannot meet all their demands. We simply have not got the accommodation there to do so. So we're obviously going to continue to discuss with them. But I think if we move on the three fronts that I talked about, then I hope that that will, to some extent, satisfy the demands that are being made, although we cannot comply with all of them.